6 ways to make coffee healthier. You already probably drink coffee, and coffee is a healthy drink. But there are some things you can do to increase the benefits of coffee and reduce any potential negative side effects of coffee. It boosts your metabolism and thyroid levels. It's also an antioxidant. It aids digestion because it's a bitter kind of herb which tends to aid digestion. It has some protective benefits for brain health. It also is quite high in magnesium and vitamins. The problem for you may be that if you drink coffee, you get jittery and nervous, or your hands and feet perhaps start feeling cold, or if you take it too late in the day, you can't sleep at night. These are signs that maybe your liver is not able to process the caffeine well. This is especially true for people who are on low-carb diets, because low carbs lower liver energy and reduce the speed of the liver's processing. When you drink coffee, your metabolism does speed up, and this is a good thing. A faster metabolism means you do a lot of things better. A lot of processes in the body work better. However, a faster metabolism is like having a faster car. It uses up fuel faster. So, when you have a fast metabolism, you must support it with more fuel. This is especially true if you're not that healthy. If you're not that healthy, maybe you don't have good exercise, nutrition, lifestyle habits, you have high stress, your liver is not able to produce and store glycogen properly. That means that when the metabolism speeds up because of, for example, coffee, you're not able to support it with fuel. So to get the maximum amount of benefits from coffee with the minimum side effects, you want to support the new faster metabolism that coffee gives you. Here are 6 things you can do to maximize the benefits of coffee. Number 1, eat a meal when you drink coffee. This meal should have some protein as well as some carbohydrates. Protein is important because protein helps slow down the release of the caffeine. And fruit would be the ideal choice for carbohydrate because fruit has fructose, which fills up liver glycogen. Number 2, I would drink the coffee with milk and sugar. Yes, milk and sugar. One of the sad things about the so-called fitness industry is that they suggest lots and lots of black coffee. But black coffee stimulates metabolism, but it's good to have milk and sugar in the coffee to support it. Milk has protein and some carbohydrates, and sugar is half fructose. So it serves the same purpose as the fruit in the meal from point number 1. The more difficulty you have processing coffee, the more I would suggest adding some sugar to the coffee. For myself, the later in the day I take the coffee, the more sugar I add, so that it affects my sleep less. Tip number 3, don't drink coffee on an empty stomach early in the morning if coffee gives you problems. Because early in the morning is the time when you have lowest liver glycogen. Have some breakfast, have some fruit, then have the coffee. Tip number 4, if you have trouble handling the fast metabolism that coffee gives you, you can consider starting out with cold coffee. The warmer the coffee, the more stimulating it is. Try cold coffee first. Tip number 5, add a multivitamin if you don't have a lot of fruit and vegetables in your diet. When your liver processes caffeine, it uses up vitamins and minerals to do this process. So if you don't have enough, the processing will be slower. There is some genetics involved with this also, but we can't really change that. Some genes influence the liver's processing speed, but we can't really change that. So we can give the liver that you do have the most possible support and nutrients. Finally, tip number 6, I would take note of what time I currently cannot tolerate coffee after, and it affects my sleep. So for me, maybe if I take it after 7 p.m, it affects my sleep. So I just take note not to do it at that time. As your health improves, as your liver glycogen production improves, as your coffee processing improves, as your nutrition levels improve, you can probably tolerate coffee later and later. In fact, the sign of improved caffeine and coffee tolerance is usually a sign of improved health. Remember, health is not something that's a right that's given to you for free. It's something you have to fight for, so fight smart and fight hard. And this channel will help give you the tools to help you fight. Hope these tips improve your life because you can enjoy coffee better. For more science-based health tips, subscribe to my channel, click on the notification bell so you don't miss any of these tips.